NP later on this morning. At tignan natin, we will now go straight into the draft, mga kaibigan. Virtus Pro taking game number one despite giving away the Meepo to Abed. At medyo okay lang, tamang kalma lang ang mga kaganapan dito. At tignan natin kung ano magiging pick for both teams. Virtus Pro going for a Tuskar, Centaur, Warrunner, Sun King, and Enigma naman ang pick dito remaining for Digital Chaos. Virtus Pro again not banning reserve yung Meepo ni Abed dito. So, tignan natin mga kaibigan kung anong magiging pick, kung pipick pa ba ng Digital Chaos ang Meepo ni Abe dito. Sama-sama nating alamin yan. Binabati ko pa rin yung mga tao dito sa chat.
DC's turn to
at mga gising pa rin o kaya mga kagigising pa lang. At happy Father's Day dahil linggo na.
Dire team back.
Ito, may nagsuchat sa akin mga tropa peeps natin sa Abu Dhabi, sa Dubai.
10 seconds remaining.
At mga kaibigan natin sa Middle East, sa mga seaman daw.
DC's turn to ban.
Mahirap ang internet sa dagat, ha? Paano yun? Pero kung may mga nanonood pa rin, siguro mataas ang kanyang mga rango.
Ten seconds remaining.
At tignan natin ang mga current band heroes. Ah, binan na ng Virtus Pro yung Meepo. Meepo, Pac, CM, Clockwork ang band nila rito. Digital Chaos going for a Darkseer, Wisp, Silencer, and Warlock.
10 seconds.
At tignan natin. So, medyo debated dahil hindi na binigay. We only give Meepo once. Hindi kayo nanalo. Hindi na kayo bibigyan ng chance ng Virtus Pro. And Virtus Pro, they will look to make a clean sweep dito sa series natin, trying to take down Digital Chaos 2-0. At tignan natin dito, Enigma Sun King. Ano ang gagawin dito ng Digital Chaos with this pick? And tignan natin kung sino ang magiging offlane. Usually offlane Enigma para sa meta ngayon. And mukhang support Sun King na to ni Lil. Enigma probably ni Nine pa siya, pero siya, ay hindi pala, baliktad pala ako, Digital Chaos pala yung ano rito. Malamang Enigma ni ano to, ni offlane god ng sipping offlane god ng Digital Chaos, Bresi.
5 seconds remaining.
Si Forev, nga pala.
Reserve time.
So, tignan natin dito. Sun King, malamang si Dubo to. O kaya, si Bulba. Virtus Pro going for two tanky heroes. They have the Center Warrunner Tuskar. Plus, they have a Shadow Demon na hindi na gano'n napipili. Pero, pinili nila. So, tignan natin dito. Ano ang magiging counter pick for Digital Chaos? They will go for an Earth Spirit and Virtus Pro.
DC's turn to
without wasting any second. Luna kaagad ang pinili nila rito. So Shadow Demon all in Luna ang pick nila. Medyo going back to the older meta heroes na Luna plus SD, easy win, easy life, easy game. Sa so, mga most of the team na gumagamit ng Luna, at tignan natin dito kung ano ang magagawa na itong lineup na to ng Virtus Pro. Paano ka ka-counter ng Digital Chaos itong lineup na to ng Virtus Pro? If ever umabot ng mid game to, this will be a very difficult hold for DC since mababa yung risk ng Virtus Pro dito. Kasi, ano lang to eh. Baga ba, papadala mo lang yung mga illusion ni Luna gamit yung Shadow Demon and Nesgrisk, although slow siege yun. Pero at least that is very effective. And if ever this game goes late, yung split push na manggagaling sa Luna and AST will be very, very difficult. Digital Chaos going for a Queen of Pain. Probably this will be their mid lane. One of the best hero to deal or to burst out any lane. Of course, Illusion.
DC's turn to ban. Seconds remaining.
Waiting for the last pick dito. DK ang bad ng Digital Chaos dito. So tingnan natin kung ano magiging last pick nila. Weaver ang last bad naman para dito sa Virtus Pro, and it is actually a very good ban kasi si Mason, alam natin more likely Weaver lang talaga yung super effective niyang hero. Nakita mo naman last game, Venomancer yung hero niya, medyo non-impact.
Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining.
Life Stealer.
So Life Stealer.
Dire team pick.
So Life Stealer pick ang magiging carry ng Digital Chaos dito. So Queen, Life Stealer, Earth Spirit, Enigma, and Sand King pick para dito sa side ng Digital Chaos. Virtus Pro will go for I think ang kulang nila rito mid laner, another very good hero para sa kanila. For me will be the Shadow Fiend, since they have a center war runner na magbibigay sa kanila ng safety, ng disengage, even makahuli ka ng Life Stealer in face bomb dito, unless hindi ka nang i-stun, makakatakbo ka with the stampede na meron yung center war runner. Pero instead they will go for an Omni Knight. Ano ang pick na to? Solo, going for the Shadow Demon. Ah, okay. Omni Knight mid, Luna Moon Pang para kay Ramsey, Taskar for Lil, and Centaur War Runner para dito kay Nine Pasha. Yan ang lineup composition for Virtus Pro. Medyo maganda yung pick nila rito. They pick an Omni Knight, which is a very good hero to counter out the Life Stealer. Pero again, yung big team fight ultimate is nasa side ng Digital Chaos dito. They have the Sand King Epicenter, the Enigma Black Hole, the Magnetize ng Earth Spirit, yung Queen of Pain ultimate, and of course, the Life Stealer in Face Bomb. Yan ang mga pangbakbakang ano niya rito? Pangbakbakang skills ng Digital Chaos dito. So tingnan natin kung makaka-force ba ng game number 3 ang Digital Chaos and Virtus, ang Digital Chaos dito, o matutusiro na sila ng Virtus Pro. Sama-sama nating alamin ang mangyayari. We are just waiting for the game to load at sisimulan na natin itong digmaan natin. Ano sabi ng mga kaibigan natin sa chat? Yung mga nagpapabati dyan, hello, binabati ko kayo. Gumalaw yung chat, yung ano ko. Tuwang-tuwa, okay. So, okay na. Binasa ko lang yung mga chatters ng mga gising pa dito. And good morning. Happy Father's Day sa lahat ng ama na nanonood dyan. Sa mga, syempre, sa mga tatay nyo, huwag nyo kakalimutang batiin ang Father's Day at special day ngayon. Syempre, alam nyo na, kailangan din natin ma-appreciate ang mga dads. You know, hindi lang mga dad bads, mga dads natin dyan. So, let's do this, Bessie. At, game na ba? Game na. So, medyo nakapost lang yung game natin dito. Gina Rao, at game na tayo mga kaibigan dito. Again, muli natin ipakilala ang mga gumagamit para dito sa magkabila ang Team Bulba, Sun King, Abed, ang Queen of Vain, Forev, ang Enigma, Mason, ang Life Stealer dito, Dubo, ang Earth Spirit. Solo will be using the Shadow Demon, Ramsey on the Luna. No one ang Omni Knight dito. Nine Pasha ang Centaur War Runner, and of course Lil will be using the Tuskar. Okay, so ito na, tingnan natin kung paano magiging laning ng magkabilang team. Sito, will they go for a standard lane o both teams medyo magbigyan natin kung anong adjustment, pero Virtus Pro, they will be able to catch itong Lifestealer dito. Tingnan natin, Shadow Demon leading the charge. Here comes the block, and Lifestealer, he is in grave danger, and this will be the first blood. No one, and Virtus Pro will get the first blood, and they might be able to secure runes as well. Pero Sand King already on the top lane. Itong si Bulba will try to contest yung bounty rune, and I think Luna will not be on time para makuha yung bounty rune na yun. Pero hindi, mukhang iniwan na ni Bulba, and mukhang this will be a first blood plus 3 bounty rune set up para dito sa side ng Virtus Pro. Pero kita mo naman Ramsey, medyo hindi siya, uy, walang na mali yata yung pwesto ng wards na yun, pero hindi natin sure yan. Pero tingnan natin, mukhang ang mga bounty rune eh nakuha ng Virtus Pro, and they are about to find their third bounty rune of the game. Pag dumaan dito yung STE, and I think he will be able to find that bounty rune and observer ward, easy life para dito sa Shadow Demon, and what a good start para dito again sa start sa side ng Virtus Pro, the Russians, mga kaibigan. Pero tignan natin dito. Virtus Pro, mga kaibigan. Let's see what will be the play for Virtus Pro dito. Omni Knight mid up against the Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain, of course, meron siyang natural advantage over the Omni Knight. Pero Omni Knight, once na makuha niya yung level niya, will be able to, of course, lane well against the Queen of Pain, since he will be able to dispel and heal almost every damage na ibabato sa kanya ng Queen of Pain dito. Pero at the moment, Queen of Pain, you're capitalizing doon sa fact na medyo low level pa lang yung Omni Knight, at hindi pa ganun ka useful or ganun pa kalakas yung sustain niya sa lane. Kita mo naman, another Shadow Strike, pero immediately repelled by the Omni Knight. Pero he needs to be careful dahil Queen of Pain can hit hard dito pa rin sa laning natin. Earth Spirit will miss his mark dito. Taskar, Ice Shard, not connecting. At they won't be able to punish itong si Dugu for that overextension. Enigma ni Forev, mga kaibigan, is in the offlane. He is sitting at level 2. Taskar will try to flank him. Pero hindi. He will just get the bounty rune, and this is a very good steal dahil makakuha na niya yung enigma ng bounty rune dito. Shadow Strike on that mid lane. Omni Knight will be able to debuff again yung damage ng Shadow Strike na yon, or with that level 1 na repel, alam niya na yon. Di ko alam, wala akong alam, hindi ako makapag-comment sa sinabi ni 1437 dahil of course opinion niya yun. Opinion niya yun sa nangyari sa kanila. Pero ako, totoo, unfair naman talaga yung nangyari sa kanila para sa akin. Biglang nagkagalon, biglang nagpapalit ng rules sa gitna ng tournament. Eh, wala tayong magagawa, nangyari na. Maganda pa rin naman yung pinakita ng TNC doon, even though medyo nag-fall off short sila, natalo yata sila sa Planet Odd. So, sayang yung run ng TNC. Pero again, maganda pa rin pinakita ng mga boys from TNC doon. So, props pa din sa kanila. Pero balik tayo sa laban natin na to. Abed and Company, down Radiant's one game dito sa lower bracket. If ever they lose this game, they will be out of the summit. So, kailangan nilang humugot ng panalo rito. Well, maganda ang simula nila in terms of last hit and deny. Lifestealer and Queen of Pain, they are leading the game. Omni Knight is leading para dito sa Dire side. Pero yun, chinupo-chupo siya rito. Orb of Venom is up on the Omni Knight. Pero, paano mo nga gagamitin yung Orb of Venom kung di mo naman mapapalo si Queen of Pain? Pero tingnan natin dito. Bumubote-bote pa. Itong si No One dito. Hindi, nakasmoke yung Sun King dito. They will try to look for a kill. Caustic Finale has been up. Here is the stun. Follow. Omni Knight will be able to use his heal. Delikado siya rito. And one more hit. He might die. And yes, he will die. Shadow Demon is here. And he might die as well. Delikado buhay niya dito. Another impale will connect and he will fall. Aishard connecting on one. Will they be able to make Dubu pay for this? And they will get a return kill dito, Virtus Pro. It will be the center war runner to get that kill. But again, they will lose two on that mid lane, including their prized Omni Knight. Maganda ang simula again para dito sa side ng Digital Chaos. Pero 2-2 pa rin ang ating scoreline in terms of kills dito sa laban natin na to. No one on the mid lane, not the usual heroes na ginagamit ni No One sa mid lane. Usually we see him on the SF, on the Templar Assassin, but this time he is on a more defensive oriented hero, which is the Omni Knight. And with this kind of pick, alam natin na they are confident with the lineup that they have. They have the Luna, which is ang playstyle para sa Luna is just make Luna survive until the late game or the mid game, kung saan makukuha niya na yung mga early defensive items niya. Pero tignan natin dito, Enigma trying to go for the chase. Here comes the Earth Spirit, hindi tatama yung stun niya rito. There's that silence coming in, there's the counter impale para dito sa side ng Digital Chaos, and they will be able to find that kill on the Tuskar. So Digital Chaos with two hero rotation towards that, and immediately they will head on towards the shrine for region, and they will be okay back into the laning phase pa rin dito. Omni Knight is 2-2 in terms of net worth. Lifestealer is 2-4 para sa Queen of Pain. Enigma is 2,000. Centaur is just 1-8. Luna is just 1-8 as well. At ito nakita si Dubu and si Solo dito, that Solo will be able to secure that bounty rune. Shadow Demon, they will be able to find the Enigma. Enigma is in danger. There's the trap. And this is a dead Enigma. Pero maraming Edelons dito. Sun King is here as well. There's that Impale. Tignan natin kung mapapatay niya ang Shadow Demon. Pero Shadow Demon will be able to walk away. There's the stun. Connecting Queen of Pain, blinking in. Here is the wave double kill for Abed. And he might get a triple dito. Double damage rune has been popped. Pero nagtatatakbo dito si Lil. Lil, will he be able to survive? There's that snowball to delay the inevitable. Sa napunta niya rito, he will go there and he will go down. And that is three heroes dead on the side of Virtus Pro and Digital Chaos. Racking up some kills dito. Very good rotation coming in from Abed, taking part of those three kills. That is a very huge advantage going in favor of Queen of Pain. And as you can see, he is now the leading hero in terms of net worth dito. Radiant's middle tower. Hand of Midas, attack. I think, will be the item choice for the Omni Knight dahil meron siyang Glove of Haste dito. Pero ito, SD, nagpalubog na naman. Palubogers, Creepers. Centaur War Runner sitting at level 6. Stampede is now up. Dubu with a kick. Tignan natin sa pupunta rito. And Dubu will just be will just use his rolling yung kanyang skill para tumakbo. The rolling boulder, level 3 si Dubu. Meron siyang infused raindrop and orb of venom. Luna is number 4 in terms of net worth, pero 1k behind over his counterpart, which is yung si Lifestealer. In the Lifestealer is now the leading hero in terms of network farming uncontested dito towards his bottom lane. Hand of Midas will be up on him very very soon, and this is a very good timing para sa kanyang Hand of Midas. Under 10 minutes and leading in terms of network. Medyo yayaman ang yayaman itong si Mason dito. Tignan natin dito mid lane natin. They will try to go for a kill on Abed. There's the disruption, pero hindi abol ang cast animation. Although the spin will be here, Invis will be pop, and Abed will be able to walk away out of harm's way dito. Mm-hmm. Luna is sitting at level 6, number 5 siya in terms of network dito, so mababa yung network niya. Abed is under the cover of invisibility, pero may mga sentry wards na nakaplant sa mid lane dito. Abed is half in terms of HP, pero wala namang initial stun na mabilis dito. Eh. Kumbaga kinakapos ng initiation dito yung Virtus Pro. Here comes the roll, the stabby. They will be able to connect on the Sun King. Sun King will be able to blink to impel out dito, pero ultimate will be pop. Patay mga kaibigan ng Center War Runner. Patay din dito ang Enigma, and they will be able to get the Sun King. So 2-for-1 exchange across the map. Tuskar will survive, and he will be able to place a very, very deep ward dito sa pagitan ng Tier 1 tower and Tier 2 tower. I think hindi niya kailangan nilagay. So tamang relax lang siya dyan. Hindi niya nilagay. Hiding lang siya dito. Minus is now up on the Lifestealer on top of a face boots. So, okay lang. Silipin mo yung graph direct kung anong graph natin. 2K gold lead going in favor of Digital Chaos, and experience is also 2K up dito sa side ng DC. So, they are in a pretty good spot. 10 minutes into the game. Here is a smoke rotation para sa side ng Digital Chaos. Queen of Pain ni Abed and the Earth Spirit of Lumu. They are heading towards the top lane. Pero at the moment, this is Luna and SD. They are clearing yung stock na meron sila rito. And they will just back off mid lane ng Punteria dito. Lifestealer is here. Queen of Pain is here as well. So tignan natin. Omni Knight is on the mid lane. There's the fortification. They will be looking to defend this Tier 1 tower in the mid lane. Pero mukhang nagbago ang isip nila rito. They are approaching from the west side, mga kaibigan. There's the disruption. Tingnan natin kung aabot. There's no stun to follow. Ang ganda ng rolling boulder, pero snowball, rolling boulder, walang nagawa. Parehas, mga kaibigan. And that is a very good engage. I mean, disengagement para sa side ng DC, not giving BP any kills dun sa pagkakataon na yon. They force out the fortification to sa mid lane. Lifestealer back again dito sa bottom lane, and I think he is now building towards that armlet. Pero may nilubog sila rito. Queen of Pain, of course, hindi siya mapapano or maano rito dahil wala namang initiating stun, instant stun yung Virtus Pro dito. Hanggat wala pa yung Centaur Blink Dagger. Enigma hand up, Midas is up on him. So Midas Gaming para sa magkabilang team natin. Center War Runner, magpapakita siya rito. Tingnan natin kung binibait out yung Rage. Pero nandito ang Sun King, and he needs to be careful. This will be a dead tower. There's the disruption. Will he be able to time yung stun dito? At mukhang hindi. Rage TP out para sa Lifestealer, and he will be able to get that Tier 1 tower on that bottom lane. So Radiant's top tower. Maganda pinapakita ng Digital Chaos dito. Sun King and SD magtatagpo sila rito, pero SD will be able to get that range ng disruption. I don't think he is even trying. Best bomb, Bell of Discord up on your Queen of Pain, looking for a potential kill towards the mid lane ang Digital Chaos dito. Sun King will be spotted na nandito sa may punuan. Tignan natin kung anong gagawin nila rito. Will they be able to go for the initiation? Oy, pero this is a very good bait para sa side ng Digital Chaos. Delikado ang Luna Moonbang dito pag na-impale siya. Although nandito ang buong kupunan, this might be the perfect opportunity for both teams to strike. Nagkakaroon ng hanapan dito, mga kaibigan. Delikado ang Digital Chaos dito. Here comes the impale. Tignan natin the follow-up, the impest bomb, pero hindi. There's that stoppy, the wave connecting on multiple heroes. Here is the Earth Spirit, the Omni Knight, the Black Hole, the Magnetize has been canceled. Low 8 on HP dito ang Virtus Pro, pero wala pang namamatay sa side nila rito. At mukhang nagkakabakbakan. Here comes the Ice Shard, Lifestealer being microed at the moment. Tuskar is the first casualty. At nagkaroon ng palubugan technique dito, nahuli si SD. This might be another kill going in favor of Digital Chaos, and yes, they will be able to find that kills on the supports. Although hindi nila nakuha yung kill on the Luna and on the Omni Knight and even on the Center War Runner. Center War Runner almost going down dun sa pagkakataon na yun, pero nabuhay siya.
Blessings.
vengeance upon a loyal warrior.
Oscar going for an arcade boots. Oh, ni item check nga tayo direct.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Okay, so Veil of Discord. Ano yung buboy ni Abed? Yule Scepter. Enigma, Midas, Arcane, going for dagger, armlet now up on your lifestealer. Atubad si Dubo rito. Samantala, etong si Solo. Uy, they will try to go dito, delikado. Etong Tuskar dito, Abed trying to go for the kill. He will immediately blink it, pero here comes the repel. Eye Shard, hindi tatama. And Abed will be able to walk away, mga kaibigan. And I think kahit tumama yun, mapapatay nila. Hindi pa level 6 yung Tuskar dito eh. Sand King opting to go for a blink dagger next as his next item. 1-3 gold up on him. So, tignan natin dito. Clearing now the ancient stock, mga kaibigan, ng Luna Moonpang dito. And he needs this stock. Kailangan niya yan para makahabol siya in terms of overall network. He is actually catching up quite well dito dahil number 4 siya dito eh. Pero tignan natin dito, Eye Shard. Trying to protect the Luna. Omni-Knight will be here as well for additional sustain. And this is a lot of experience going in favor of Team Virtus Pro. Luna now up on the number 3 spot in terms of overall network. But this is a very big item pickup. The Enigma now up with the Blink Dagger. Tignan natin kung he will be able to find that kill na, or that opening na kailangan ng Digital Chaos dito. Para ma-team wipe yung Virtus Pro. That black hole, that is their main weapon dito sa mga teamfight engagement. Luna, Omni Knight, number 2 and number 3 respectively in terms of overall network dito, just behind the Lifestealer. Pero Lifestealer at the moment farming uncontestedly. Luna opting to go for a Yasha as his first item dito on top of a Power Dreads and the Mask of Madness. Abed going for Yule Scepter for additional micro. Sun King, napapalapit na mga kaibigan yung ano niya rito. Yung Blink Dagger niya, and he will be able to find that Blink Dagger in a bit. He is now up to 2,000 gold dito sa laban natin na to. Center War Runner also nearing the timing ng Blink Dagger niya rito. Sun King is just 140 gold short of that Blink Dagger. He will be the one to defend the bottom lane, and after that this creep wave, medyo ayun na, buo na yung Blink Dagger Reno Mastery niya rito. There's Center War Runner, tignan natin, he popped that Stampede and he will be able to walk away dito. Pero that is a very expensive escape for your Center War Runner. This might open up things from the side of Digital Chaos since that Stampede won't be up and available sa mga susunod na engagement. Sand King now up with the Blink Dagger. Luna is now your leading hero in terms of overall network. Blink Dagger completed on your Center War Runner. Taskar is now at level 6. And Arcane Boots is now up on him. So, medyo maganda yung mga timing ng mga item para dito sa magkabila ang teams natin. Nakukuha na nila yung mga item progression nila rito. Even the Omni Knight is 2,700 in terms of the money na meron siya. He is now building towards the Radiance. A very good item para sa kanya rito. Tignan natin. Oscar gumulong. Hinabol. Tignan natin. Eye Shard will not be able to connect again on that Queen of Pain. And Queen of Pain will be able to walk away into safety. And BP struggling to find that kill on the elusive Queen of Pain. Omni Knight popping his Ace Rune at back into the safety of their territory. Enigma now building towards the BKB, and he is now up with the good Drill Hammer sa gold na meron siya. If he opt out to buy that Drill Hammer, the blink, the BKB timing niya will be very very good. Maybe even before mag 20 minutes yung laro natin, makuha niya na yung BKB timing niya. Bulba! Si Bulbasaur, mga kaibigan. 4K gold lead being enjoyed by Digital Chaos at the moment. There's the scan spatting out itong si Bulba dito. So alam nilang nandito si Bulba. Pero tingnan natin, Bulba being able to blink out dito. Maghanap sila ng Eye Shard. Not catching a glimpse nitong Sand King, mga kaibigan. And he will be able to spot that. Uy, nahuli. Walrus Punch connecting dito. Pero di ko alam kung mapapatay nila. Sand King, not enough mana for a impale out. And the Sand King will fall, which means that the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane will fall in favor of Virtus Pro. And Sand King hanging so long dun sa bottom lane na yon. At pag nakuha nila to, Relic is now up on your Omni Knight dahil meron siyang 4,200 gold. Easy farming para sa kanya rito. Number 2 in terms of overall network. And this network will just skyrocket as the game progresses since Radiance yung binubuo niya rito. Of course, malaking tulong yan, especially against the Queen of Pain na Roma right click, sa Lifestealer na Roma right click, yung evasion na kahit pa paano na binibigay ng Radiance will help them in towards that department ng laban natin, which is yung mischance dito. Pero nahuli nila rito si Shadow Demon. Shadow Demon will be able to delay ang kanyang pagkamatay dito. But still, he will fall. So Abed will be on a unstoppable streak dito. That could have been worse for Virtus Pro. Pero nahuli yung support nila ron. SNY will be the next item para dito sa Lifestealer. Radiance is now up on the Omni Knight. So masakit yan kahit papano. Game number 2, mga besi. Virtus Pro taking game number 1 of this potential best of 3 series natin. Sand King blinking in aggressively, trying to clear itong creep wave na nagpo-push. Samantala, SD and the rest of BB, they are converging towards this mid lane. They will try to capitalize on the regions that they have. They want this tower. Tingnan natin, mga kaibigan. They are starting to chip away the health of Abed, mga kaibigan. And this tier 1 tower in the mid lane will fall. Fortification will just delay the inevitable, of course. Magkakaroon naman ng reset ng fortification once that tier 1 tower falls. And this will be a continued pressure para dito sa side ng BP. And the use of SD and Luna Illusions plus the Radiance and of course Omni Knight sitting on the backside. This will be a very, very difficult push to fend off coming in from Virtus Pro. Pero BP, they won't be risking yung kanilang ano rito. Lifestealer popping yung kanyang Rage. He will just back off. SNY completed on him. And I don't think that's the right play. At least dapat hintayin niya munang may nag-TP to defend yung bottom lane bago siya nag-back yung Lifestealer. So medyo tama lang, tamang relax lang dito. Manta style completed on your Luna and he is the leading hero in terms of network dito sa laro natin. Now up to 12k, 22 minutes into the game. Silipin natin yung network natin direct. De, grab. Yung, so medyo nag-plateau na rito sa 4k yung kalamangan ng Digital KO. So silipin natin yung experience still at 4k, pero ito ultimate will be pop. Nagkakaulihan, they will be able to take down that Earth Spirit. Medyo massive nagalawan coming in from the side of Digital Chaos. And tignan natin kung makakahabol pa dito ang Virtus Pro. So they try to go for more and they will be able to find Abed, mga kaibigan, getting caught and he has no buyback, so he will be down for 43 seconds. This tier 2 tower say goodbye to it, DC. And medyo lapses in terms of decision making, overextending. And kawawa sila rito. BKB will be up on your Luna Moonfang as well. Illusion plus Disruption Illusion. Apat na Illusion. Easy push para dito sa side ng Virtus Pro. And that is a tier 2 tower down on that mid lane. And they immediately they will refocus their attention towards the top lane, which meron pang tier 1 tower dun, yung Digital Chaos. So Sand King going for a 4-step as his next item dito. 24 minutes into the game. Centaur War Runner opting to go for a 4 stop as well. And here is Digital Chaos in Fistbump again para sa kanila rito, looking for a potential kill. Pero sama-sama lang ang Virtus Pro dito. They will pop the shrine at mukhang magkakaroon ng bakbakan dito sa may bandang mid lane. Sand King is under the cover of invisibility, looking for that opportunity to strike. Pero SD will be spotted. Alam nilang naglagay kitang-kita sa Akto. Pinalubog. Huling buwag. Huling kabalbon. Lifestealer investing na natin dito. Lifestealer trying to chase that SD. Pero Blink in Guardian Angel. Snowball to save. And take na natin kung magkakaroon ng Ace Engage dito. Black Hole on the Luna. Pero Luna, tignan natin, he will be able to pop his BKB. Lumalaban siya dito. Tignan natin, dalawa na patay. Patay ang Center War Runner. Patay dead. Pero tignan natin, there's the Rebel. Two heroes dead on the side of Virtus Pro. They are looking for more. Digital Chaos will find the third. And the Black Hole, even though it is a lackluster Black Hole, they will be able to find that kill on three heroes. And they will be able to find four. Digital Chaos, they are... That is a very good engagement for them, and that might open up the Roshan for the rush up for the North American squad. Digital Chaos, great fight para dito sa side ng Digital Chaos. Is Taskar, tignan natin, susubukan nila mag-contest. Shard, Bineki, there's multiple TP dito, no ultimate unavailable on the side of Digital Chaos, and Luna is here walking towards the Rosh Pit. Delikado, nagpapasok ng Illusion. There's that Eye Shard, the silence, mga kaibigan. And they will back off. Hindi nila kaya yung puwersa doon. So tignan natin kung anong gagawin dito ng DC. Since mababa ang buhay ng Roshan, they will pop the shrine para maging good to go sila sa susunod na engagement. BKB up on your Luna Moonbang. At meron pa siyang ultimate dito available. So may BKB, may repel. Bakbakan na to. And Luna pumasok sa loob ng Rosh Pit dito. Lifestealer, tignan natin, Omni-Knight is here, nagkakaroon ng abangan, Ice Shard, connect, Lifestealer, gusto pumasok, at pumasok ang Lifestealer dito. So tignan natin, there's that Impale, 2-man Impale, tignan natin kung mabubuhay ang Luna, and hindi niya mag-pump yung BKB niya. And that is the SD going down as well, so masyadong nga-assame ang Virtus Pro doon. They will give up that the highest network hero, yung Luna, he will fall, and this will be Roshan for Digital Chaos. Good series of event para sa kanila rito. Centaur War Runner being chased down. He will blink towards the northern part of the map. Mahuhuli siya rito. Here comes that Enigma with the stun. And again, another follow-up stun. Centaur War Runner with the stop. Hindi ko konekta. At takas. Patay. Yatapchi, mga kaibigan. Ang bakang nagangalang Centaur War Runner and BP. Medyo... binibigay nila. Marami silang binibigay na kill dito sa side ng Digital Chaos. Pero tignan natin dito. Taskar. Earth Spirit is here. Medyo gulong. Double gulong technique, mga kaibigan, and Earth Spirit will be able to roll away from certain danger. Butterfly is the next item for your Luna, pero with the damage, magic damage verse na meron yung Virtus Pro. And the moment na ma-chain stun siya, ma-chain disable siya, hindi siya makapag-BKB o ma-repel, that would be the end of the Luna Moonbang dito. Dagger will be up on your Taskar as is the next item, and that is a very good defensive item para sa isang Taskar, of course, being able to blink in and snowball instantly to save yung teammate mo na nasa panganibe. Napakalaking tulong, especially kung hindi ka mahuhuli ng black hole, hindi ka masasilence, maniligtas may mga kampi mo. Meron Digital Chaos, medyo they have aid the momentum dito, pero still, the two leading hero in terms of overall network is on the side of BB. Queen of Bain ni Abed now opting to go for a Shiva's Guard. That's his next item. Rage being popped by the Lifestealer dito. Tignan natin kung mapapalubog siya. Here comes the Impale coming in. Delegado rito ang Shadow Demon, and the Shadow Demon will fall. They will consider Shadow Demon dito. Pero delikado yung Torre nila. Hindi nila madepensahan. Hindi na normal na rito ng Digital Chaos. Ang Tier 3 Tower dito. No SP to save the day. Here is the silence. Here comes the Omni-Knight trying to blink in dito. Pero against that Lifestealer, delikado siya. And the Lifestealer will just be able to arm the toggle on and off into safety dito.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
SD will be up on 6. Here comes the Omni-Knight. Mga kaibigan, trying to defend the Tier 3 will fall. Here comes the Wild Response connecting on the Lifestealer. Will they try to go for more? I don't think so. And the LS and DC, they will be able to walk away with that blunder. Digital Chaos, they are on a tear. Kahit papano, Mecha ang gustong buuin ng Omni-Knight dito. I think Graves is a very very good item para sa kanila sa laro natin na to. To negate yung damage ng at least nung Epi or ng Sonic Wave ng Queen of Pain will be very very useful, especially for the Luna and Ramsey. 17k in terms of network butterfly is almost complete on your Luna dito. So maganda ang maganda pa rin despite being down by 10 kills. Medyo may chance pa rito ang Virtus Pro with the Luna, with the ultimate late game hero na meron sila. They have a pretty decent chance of taking this game even though medyo malaki ang kalamangan dito ng Digital Chaos. So tignan natin dito, medyo going towards the 10k mark yung kalamangan ng network ng Digital Chaos dito. And BP opting not to go for any engagement hanggat naka-up pa yung Aegis para sa Lifestealer dito. Shiba now completed on your Queen of Pain. Aegis is still up, so they will be gunning for this mid lane. Tignan natin dito, Taskar with the Wild Response. And Lifestealer, medyo delikado siya rito. Here comes the stun coming in from that Earth Spirit. Pero Luna under the protection of the Repel. And medyo Manta style and illusion muna sila rito. So yan ang pampush nila rito. Yan ang kanilang very good pushing lineup. Pero tignan natin dito, Lifestealer trying to take down itong shrine dito. Luna is here, iwan pop the shrine. Fusion Beam connecting. Aegis will be reclaimed. Tignan natin Luna with a stampede. Hindi nila aabutan dito. And DC will be able to walk away with that shrine being taken down. So they will lose BP yung control nila dun sa bottom part ng gubat.
The time.
Abed with an Orchid, Midas, and now opting to go for a Maelstrom. So this is a right-click type Queen of Pain para kay Abed. Octarin Core completed on the Enigma as well. And Greaves now up on your Omni-Knight. Butterfly will be up very, very soon. Para dito sa Luna natin, or sa Luna ni Ramsey. SD, medyo makakahabol na siya sa mga farm na yun. Tingnan natin. Dahil nga mayroon siyang, ayun o, kita mo naman o. Easy money matching. The illusion is real. And Ghost Scepter ang napiling item choice dito ng Shadow Demon. And preparing for an engagement dito ang Digital Chaos. They naka-infest bomb na tong si ano rito, Lifestealer sa loob ng Sand King. So they are looking for the opening. They might find the opening na hinahanap nila dun sa bottom lane na hero ng Virtus Pro. They might walk into a trap. At ito mga kaibigan, the stun. Uy, meron na silence dito. Guardian Grip delikado. Black Hole connecting on 3. Luna will fall. And the Black Hole, even the Omni-Knight might fall, mga kaibigan. And they will lose 4 heroes doon sa pagkakataon na yun. No buyback on the Luna for 60 seconds. 66 naman sa Omni-Knight. And Well played. At delikado sila mga kaibigan. This might be GG, the GG push. The perfect engagement para sa Digital Chaos. And they might find this skill and GG will be called. And Digital Chaos will be able to force a game number 3 at evening up the series. Great start para sa DC and they never look back dito. At yun ang nangyari, medyo Virtus Pro, kung kailan nabuo nila yung mga item nila, that big item, the big butterfly pickup para sa Luna Moonfang nila, inaubo sila. That engagement sa may gubat ng Radiant side, nahuli sila without any buyback on those 4 heroes na namatay. Easy GG call para sa Virtus Pro and DZ will take that game number 2. So we will go to a decider, a game number 3 dito mga kaibigan. So kung ako sa inyo, huwag na kayo, yung mga gising pa, manatili kayong gising dahil may game 3 tayo. Babalik ako or babalik kami for game number 3 action. Again, you are watching the Summit 7 Digital Chaos versus Virtus Pro. Again, this is Duno and this is Mineski TV. We'll be back. They like to leave that behind. Sometimes I ask God, man, why him? Like the team that I would never leave behind. I